Good morning, children. So everybody is ready with the textbook? Okay. So yesterday we saw about the additive identity, multiplicative identity, reciprocal of a number and negative of a number. Today we are going to start another topic, that is distributive over addition. Distributive over addition means, what is the meaning of distributivity? Distributivity means to distribute. For example, if I write like this way, 2 upon 3 multiplied by 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3, suppose. Then that will give me 2 upon 3 multiplied by 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3 multiplied by 1 upon 3, like this way. Means 2 upon 3 will get distributed with this and this number with the addition sign in between. Now let us solve this. Okay, so when I start with solving, I have to see. Let me start with LHS. Okay, what is LHS? So 2 upon 3 multiplied by, when I solve this bracket, when I cross multiply, I get 3 plus 2 whole upon 3 twos are 6. So that is equal to 2 upon 3 multiplied by 3 plus 2 is 5. So 5 upon 6. So what will be answer? 2 5s are 10. 10 upon 18. So that is equal to 2 5s are 10 and 2 9s are 18. We got the answer as 5 upon 9. Now let me solve the RHS and verify whether both are same. Now this is 2 upon 3 plus 1 upon 2. So answer will be 2 upon 6. 2 1s are 2 and 3 2s are 6 plus 2 upon 9, right? Okay, now I solve this. So 9 2s are 18 plus 6 2s are 12 whole upon 6 9s are 54. So that gives me 18 plus 12, 30. So 30 upon 54. So 54. So if I cancel it, it goes in the table of 6. 6 5s are 30. So 6 5s are 30 and 6 9s are 54. So I got the answer as 54. So which proves that LHS is equal to RHS. So there goes the distributivity over addition means, when you are stuck up while solving the sums at this point, you have to apply this distribution. That is, this 2 upon 3 will get multiplied with this, and then this 2 upon 3 will get multiplied with this with the plus sign in between. Okay, fine. So now we start with exercise 1.1. Everybody please open exercise 1.1. And we start with question number 2 first. Okay. In exercise 1.1, we start with first exercise, question number 2. Now see, write the additive inverse for each of the following. You have to write the additive inverse. Now additive inverse means, what you have to write in additive inverse? Where the addition is 0, the given number. So let us see the first one. First one is 2 upon 8. So 2 upon 8. So what is the additive inverse of 2 upon 8? Minus 2 upon 8. Okay. Then the second one is minus 5 upon 9. Minus 5 upon 9. What is the additive inverse? 5 upon 9. If you are given a positive number, it becomes negative. If you are given a negative number, it becomes positive. Okay, so question number 2. First 2 I have done, remaining you have to do for your homework. Fine? Okay, now question number 4. See question number 4. write the multiplicative inverse. You have to write the multiplicative inverse. Now, first is minus 13. Minus 13. So, minus 13 means what? Minus 13 upon 1. There is nothing at the denominator position, right? So, I write minus 1. Now, multiplicative inverse means what? I have to just take its reciprocal. There is no need for you to change the sign. You have to change the sign in additive inverse. You don't have to take the inverse. But in multiplicative inverse, the sign is going to remain the same. You have to take its inverse. So 13 upon 1, minus 13 upon 1, the multiplicative inverse is minus 1 upon 13. Okay? Then see the second one. Minus 13 upon 19. Minus 13 upon 19. So what is multiplicative inverse? Minus 19 upon 13. Or 19 upon minus 13. Both are same. Understood? So what is the difference between additive inverse and multiplicative inverse? Let me tell you again. In additive inverse, if you have a positive rational number, it becomes negative. Okay? Only the sign is going to change. And in multiplicative inverse, the sign will remain the same. You have to take the reciprocal. Understood? Okay. So now your homework is in exercise 1.1, question number 2 and question number 4. Complete question number 2 and question number 4 in notebook. Tomorrow we will continue further with the exercise. Okay, children, thank you. Have a nice day.